What's up everybody, it's your boy Andrew. If you're new to my channel, welcome. If not, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna talk about how much it costs to live in Denver, Colorado, and Colorado in general in 2021, as it compares to the rest of the United States. We're gonna cover everything you need to know, such as housing, groceries, taxes, transportation, and utilities. Now, if you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and smash that notification bell to be notified when I make new videos. I'll be coming out with new videos every Monday and Wednesday, talking about everything you need to know about living in Denver, moving to Denver, real estate advice in general, investing in taxes. Before we jump into it, as a quick reminder, I am a licensed real estate agent out here in Denver, Colorado. So if you have any questions whatsoever about moving here or moving anywhere in the nation and you need someone in your local market, feel free to give me a call or text at the phone number below or email me. I'll be happy to get back to you and help you in any way I can. Now, with all that out of the way, let's jump into it. According to the Cost of Living Index, Colorado as a whole is about 5% more expensive than the national average, with places like Denver itself and the Denver metro area coming in about 10 to 20% higher than the national average. This index takes into consideration some of the expenses we talked about earlier: housing, utilities, transportation, and groceries. Starting with housing, the average single family detached home in the Denver area rose to about $675,000 average price point, which is up about almost 20% year over year. It is a little bit lower in the Denver metro area as a whole. In the suburbs, some of the surrounding areas, the average is around $600,000, so it's still up there, but not quite as expensive as the city of Denver itself. While that might sound crazy, maybe to some people that aren't in expensive markets, there are affordable places around Denver. If you're looking at maybe getting a townhouse or condo, the average price point of those are in the 400s, so not quite as much as a single family. It's a great starter home to get into, just something to, if you move out here, jump into, build some equity, and then once you're comfortable where you're at, you can jump out of that, sell that into one of the single family houses that's gonna cost a little bit more. Now, if you're moving to Denver from out of state and you're, one, not sure if you wanna be here for a long time, or two, what area of the city or the suburbs you want to be in yet, it might make more sense to rent. So the average price for a one-bedroom apartment right now is about $1,300, and then the average price for a four-bedroom is about $2,600, and then you can expect 2 to 3 bedroom to be somewhere in the middle of that range, which all those prices are well above the national average. All right, so you moved to Denver, you either bought your house, bought your condo, rented an apartment, rented a house, whatever it may be. So now you've got that expense out of the way. Now how much does it cost to pretty much keep that place going with gas, electricity, water, and sewer? So you can expect the Denver utility cost to be about 6% lower than national average. Of course, we do have seasons, so you can expect in the summertime, you'll be cranking your AC a lot more, so you can expect the electricity to be a little bit higher, or winter, depending on if you have a gas or electric furnace, you'll be running that thing even more, so that bill could be higher in those months that it's really cold. And then of course, during summer, our grass here needs a lot of water, and you need to water your lawn a lot to keep it going. Luckily, our water isn't that expensive, but you'll be running it for a long time and multiple times a day during summer. Now, all that just to say, you can expect to pay around $140 to $180 a month for your utilities, the ones I mentioned: electricity, gas, water, sewer. Of course, it's all gonna be dependent on the size of your house or your apartment. So if you have a one bedroom, 700 square foot apartment, it's obviously gonna be a lot cheaper than a 6,000 square foot, 5 bed, 5 bath house. But these are the averages you're gonna be expecting. And then for your internet bill, we have CenturyLink, Comcast are our two main ones, and you can expect your internet bill to be around $60 a month or so. And of course, I don't think there's any difference between your phone bill, so no matter if you're in Kansas or you're in Colorado, your phone bill will be the same depending on the carrier you're with. Now, the next cost we gotta talk about is all about transportation. And as of now, Denver is about in line with national average in terms of transportation costs, which takes into account gas prices, registration, public transportation, just to name a few. Speaking of gas, at the time I'm making this video, gas prices out here range from about $2.70 per gallon to $2.99 per gallon. Of course, that could change day by day and week by week. So make sure to check what it is at the time that you're thinking about moving here. Quick pro tip when you're buying gas, download the Gas Buddy app. What it does is it brings up a map of the area you're in, showing you the gas prices of all the gas stations around. We do have Costco's and Sam's Clubs out here, which generally will be the lowest price gas. But if you don't have a membership or not near those, the Gas Buddy app is a great alternative to be able to find cheap gas wherever you're at. If you're bringing your car from out of state, it will cost about $25 to transfer your plates to Colorado, and then about $75 to $90 to register your vehicle. Now, these costs will vary county by county and city by city. So wherever you're moving in Colorado, make sure you check with that local DMV to see exactly what those costs will be, so you're not surprised when you move out here. Luckily, if you're in the city or near the city itself and you don't want to drive or bring a car out here or buy a car when you get out here, we actually have a very good light rail system that starts in the heart of downtown and pretty much spiders out. There's one light rail that goes to the airport, goes all the way out west, comes down south, goes up north, and you can get a one-way pass on the light rail for about $3. Or if you think you're gonna be taking the light rail a lot, let's say you work downtown and you wanna live a little bit further out of town, a monthly pass for that light rail will run you about $114 a month. So what does this all mean? Well, if you're a single adult, you can probably expect to pay around $5,000 a year or so just on transportation alone. And of course, that'll vary by how you get around, what you drive, all these different factors. Next up, let's talk about how much you'd expect to spend on food. Now, if you like to cook at home and don't expect to go out much and you want to cook meals at home and do that, you can expect to spend the national average on groceries, which will come out to about $300 per month. We don't have any crazy expensive groceries out here. We have all the regular grocery stores, King Supers, which is a Kroger brand, Safeway, and then some local Sprouts and Whole Foods. Now that's just groceries. If you want to go out and eat, you know, this isn't including alcohol, desserts, or appetizers, you can expect to spend about $15 per person at a restaurant. Of course, that's just going to go up if you're going to be buying alcohol or appetizers, as the alcohol seems to be about the most expensive thing usually. Now, if you want to go to a little bit more high-end restaurants and have a nicer experience and probably better food, you can expect to spend around $60 or so a person. Again, that's not including the alcohol, desserts, and appetizers. All right, lastly is everyone's favorite topic, and that's taxes. And when I talk about taxes, I'm saying sales taxes and your income tax. Now, Denver, unlike the federal level, has a flat tax rate instead of a marginal tax rate. So you can expect to pay about 4.63% as our rate right now on whatever you make, as opposed to something like the federal level or California, where depending on your income level, you'll be in these different tax brackets. Now, on that note of the different tax systems, comparing Colorado to California, you can expect if you're making a joint income of $150,000 to save about $5,000 a year in state income taxes. Now, this is just a rough example. There's gonna be a lot more factors that go into it, but this is just a rough estimate of where you could be. There are also additional local taxes. So if you work in a place like Aurora, Denver, Greenwood Village, and Glendale, they do have an additional tax on top of that, but it's pretty minuscule. Now, the sales tax in Denver and the metro area floats anywhere from around 8 to 8.8%. Why that is because there's a flat tax rate of about 2.9% in Colorado as a whole, and then each individual city and county has any additional taxes on top of that, and that's what brings it up to about 8% to 8.8% in Denver and the Denver metro area. All right, so that's a lot of information talking about national averages and percentages. So let's shift and talk about the other side of the equation and see what you need to be making in order to live comfortably out here and not have to stress too much about money. Now, as of 2020, the median income in Denver was about $70,000. Now, you don't need to be making $70,000 to live comfortably out here, but the recommended amount isn't too far off. It is recommended you make around $55,000 to $60,000 a year to be comfortable out here in Colorado. Of course, you're not going to be able to go out every night. You're not going to be eating really expensive meals all the time, because probably your housing expense is going to eat up most of your income, depending on where you live. But overall, $55,000 to $60,000 is the comfortable range to live out here in Denver. Well, that's it. That's what you can expect to spend living in Denver, Colorado, and how much you need to make. I hope you found this video informative. If you did and you liked it, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. If there are any videos you want me to make about anywhere in Colorado, real estate, finance, anything like that, feel free to give me a call, text, or drop a comment below, and I'll be happy to make a video on that, and we'll see you on the next one.